Hello students, welcome you all for the online session on Corporate Accounting subject of 3rd semester BCom, Bangalore City University. The title of the chapter is Valuation of Goodwill and Shares. And in the previous sessions, we have discussed about the various methods of valuation of shares that includes intrinsic value of shares method and yield method. In this session, we will work out some problems on valuation of shares under intrinsic value method and yield method. In this illustration, we are asked to compute the value of shares by the net assets method and yield method and fair value method. At the balance sheet of a limited company as on 31st March 2020 is given below. On the liability side, we have 80,000 equity shares of rupees 10 each, 8 lakhs, reserve fund 1 lakh, profit and loss account 50,000, 5% debentures 1 lakh, creditors 3 lakhs, provision for tax 1 lakh. On the asset side, we have goodwill 50,000, fixed assets 10 lakhs, current assets 4 lakhs. Total value of the balance sheet is 14 lakhs 50,000. And in the adjustments, on 31st March 2020, fixed assets were valued at rupees 12 lakhs and goodwill rupees 75,000. The net profits for the last 3 years were rupees 75,000, rupees 78,000 and rupees 87,000, of which 20% was placed to reserve. The rate of return is 10%. So this is the information provided to you in the problem. So while calculating the value of shares under net assets method, so first we need to ascertain the net assets available for equity shareholders. For that, first we have to take the market value of assets. So here, fixed assets were valued at rupees 12 lakhs, that we have to take, and goodwill rupees 75,000, and current assets we have to take 4 lakh rupees only. Then from that we have to deduct the outside liabilities, that is liabilities due to the outsiders, and that includes 5% debentures, creditors and provision for tax. And the remaining balance we can consider it as net assets available for equity shareholders, as preference share capital is not given in the problem. Based on that, we can compute the intrinsic value of share under net assets method, that is net assets available for equity shareholders divided by total number of equity shares. Here the total number of equity shares are 80,000. Then in the second method, the yield method, first we have to calculate the average profits of the company. So as you can see here, the profits of the company is increasing year after year. So therefore, we have to adopt weighted average profit method to calculate the average profits. Then in the next step, we have to calculate the dividends available for equity shareholders, that is profits available for distribution of dividends to equity shareholders. From that, first we have to take the weighted average profits of the company. From that, we have to deduct reserves of 20%. And the resulting balance, we can consider it as the net profits available for dividends to equity shareholders. In the third step, we have to compute the capitalized profits. And in the last step, we have to compute the market value of the share under yield method. Then we have to calculate the value of share under fair value method. So for the calculation of value of share under fair value method, we have to take the intrinsic value of share and market value per share, and it is the average of those two value of shares. Now let's move on to the solution part. So first we have to ascertain the net value of assets available for equity shareholders. As I already said, first we have to take the market value of assets, goodwill 75,000, fixed assets 12 lakhs, current assets 4 lakhs. Total market value of assets is 16,75,000. From that we have to deduct total liabilities due to outsiders. That includes 5% debentures 1 lakh, creditors 3 lakhs, provision for tax 1 lakh. Total amount of liabilities is 5 lakhs. 16,75,000 minus 5 lakhs, 11,75,000, that should be treated as net value of assets available for equity shareholders. And finally, we can compute the intrinsic value of equity share with the help of the formula net value of assets available for equity shares divided by number of equity shares. So net assets available for equity shares is 11,75,000 as per step 1, and the number of shares as given in the problem, it is 80,000. So we will get 14.69 rupees per share as the intrinsic value of share. Then under yield method, as I already said, first we have to compute the weighted average profits, that is profit for the last 3 years divided by total weights. So profits are 75,000, 78,000, 87,000, and the weights to be assigned are 1, 2 and 3, and the product we are going to get is 75,000, that is 75,000 into 1, 75,000, 78,000 into 2, 1,56,000, 87,000 into 3, 2,61,000. So the total product will be 4,92,000 and the total weights are 6. With that, we can compute the weighted average profits. So total product 4,92,000 divided by total weight 6, we will get the average profits as rupees 82,000. In the next step, we have to calculate the profits available for dividends to equity shareholders. In that, first we have to take the average profits of the company. From that, we have to deduct transfer to reserves. That is, on 82,000, 20%. That comes to 16,400. Therefore, the profits available for dividends to equity shareholders is 65,600. Next, in step 3, we have to calculate the capitalized profits with the help of the formula profits available for equity shareholders divided by normal rate of return multiplied by 100. Profits as per the previous step is 65,600, and the normal rate of return as given in the problem is 10% multiplied by 100. So the capitalized profits is rupees 6,56,000. In step 4, we have to compute the market value per share. And the formula for that is capitalized profits divided by number of equity shares. Capitalized profits as per step 3 is rupees 6,56,000 and the number of equity shares are 80,000. Therefore, the market value per share is rupees 8.20 per share. And finally, we have to calculate the fair value of share. So fair value is the average of intrinsic value and yield value of share. That is 14.69 plus 8.20 divided by 2, and we will get the fair value of share as rupees 11.445 per share. Thank you, students.